My name is Anna Karigund. I'm from Sweden, but I'm representing Sedesco International, an international organization for beauty and spa therapists, and I'm the president of the organization.
What do you have to say for today's event that's been organized in Mumbai?
It's been absolutely amazing. Well, incredible as India. And we've had brilliant meetings for the examiners so we can educate them. We have had schools meetings so that the schools are up to standard, since we stand for excellent standards and quality. So we always upgrade them. We've had an amazing General Assembly taking very important new executive decisions. And of course, all the social events. We've been dancing, we've had an amazing cultural night to get a taste and feel of India. And yesterday we also had a lovely gala dinner where we had an award ceremony and of course also dancing and a
Ma'am, today that was a very interesting event organized in Exhibition Center. You are the founder, you are the chairperson. What do you have to say regarding this event? Ma'am, please.
Ours is the Sedesco International Congress, 65th Congress is there. We are having almost 32 delegates countries here, and we are the founder for the complete professional education in India, which was not known. This thing, ABTC, Association of Beauty Therapy and Cosmetology, is founded in 1985. Purely to play on the Sedesco's aims is to bring professionals together, to upgrade them and to increase the professional standard. Today the conference is of 65th Congress of Sedesco, and we were dreaming that sometimes we will have this Congress in India. Our dream came true.
So we would like to wish you for this. What will be the schedule that you people are going to follow for the next day?
We had 3 days before this, we had all conferences, our meetings were there with the schools. We have 17 schools, so all of them had come from Sedesco section. And so we wanted that everybody should get to know the Sedesco board, and we had a lot of exchange of ideas how to take it forward. We educated quite a bit of our Indian delegates, and we entertained them for 3 days showing our culture, which was a big success. Now today and tomorrow we show them Ayurveda, we show them the modern side of India as well. We'll be showing them the latest techniques, the latest machines. We want to show the West that we are not behind. India is a country to reckon with. Now they think India is Sone ki Chidiya. Okay, so we are back to being in that age, and they want to come in and they want to spread the word of Sedesco, and we have done a fabulous job, and I think we have spread Sedesco very well. We've educated the Indian audience.
Where do you see Sedesco 5 years down the line?
I think we're going to go ahead with many, many schools. Many, many schools. So people will have international education. The best point is then they get employment abroad. So most of our students who are spa, they work as directors. In fact, some of them are at the back, you can interview them. And they do very well with this degree. Thanks.
Thank you so much. Yeah. Ma'am, what do you have to say for today's event that's been organized here?
Today's event actually is a benchmark or it is putting the Indian beauty industry. It is putting the Indian beauty industry on the world map today. You know, we have been into beauty from ages. Ayurveda and everything is ours. It's our beauty, but not the world actually does not recognize it at all. So today when so many delegates coming here, India is actually getting its due recognition, which we didn't get for so many years. Yeah. So I think this is a real hallmark or a mark of an event in the beauty arena. You had also asked us a question a little before to say that, what is the government doing for below the line poverty students? Okay, there is a lot of PMKBY programs which are linked to beauty. Actually, the government has got it loud and clear that this is one single industry which is an industry for tomorrow. It's a sunrise industry. So tomorrow is beauty, because any day you get up in the morning, you will look at the mirror. You will not tell the mirror, okay, do I want to look ugly today? Every day you want to look beautiful. Till we want to look beautiful, this industry is here to grow. So So this is the tomorrow's industry. So the government...
Sir. What do you have to say for today's event, sir?
Well, today is a wonderful day. It's the first CEDESCO World Congress in India. And it's the entrepreneurship and the dedication and commitment of many of these fantastic women, starting from Maya Thai and also Ms. Seema Gopuchkar, and all showing its fruits today. I think it's a great event. I mean, the organization has been fantastic. I think there are delegates from all over the world. I believe this is going to be a great learning experience, exposure to different cultures, and how CEDESCO is driving excellence throughout the world.
So this is Dr. Kannan, okay, and he's been my student, and he's very successful. He's the director and has had many good jobs. Now, where are you placed? Can you tell them?
Well, I currently work as the director of spas for the Four Seasons Resorts in Malaysia. And since the last 15 years, I've been working with various companies like the Kempinski, Four Seasons, the Ritz-Carlton. I've been involved with the pre-opening of many properties. So I think many of these things, after I started my career as an Ayurvedic doctor and a yoga teacher, the exposure, the kind of growth that I've achieved in my career would not have been possible without being associated with CEDESCO and SIPTAC. And in Mumbai, this is one place where it all started. It's a great endeavor that CEDESCO professionals from Mumbai and from other parts of India are really taking it forward, bringing in more and more people. And when I look at the last 15 years, I believe that the spa and the wellness industry, the fitness industry in India has grown so much. It has grown so much that you can't rely on unqualified professionals anymore. People now look up to India. This is a place where billions of dollars are going to come from the spa and the wellness industry. And I think moving forward, youngsters in India, and not only women, men like me, I believe, should also take up beauty and wellness as a profession. Be professionally certified, have a proper level 3 international diploma, and then come forth and present their skills. I think that would benefit the people in India the most.
And I'm happy to say that doctor employs in India as well as abroad all the students who graduate from CEDESCO. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.